Now, as some of you may know, I'm an FOV nut, and maybe I go a little overboard with it sometimes, but it's really important to me. I'm one of those people who suffer from motion sickness, and a low FOV will give me a headache all day. Not only will I not be able to enjoy the game, but I won't be able to enjoy another game or even watch a movie all day because I'm stuck with a headache, all because of a game with a low FOV. When I jump into a game, and in the settings I see that there is an FOV slider or there is a console command for one, I become very excited. This slider or code means that I will be able to set up a comfortable field of view and I will be able to enjoy the game the way I decide. Now, if you're the sort of person who doesn't suffer from motion sickness and you wonder, well, how can this benefit me then? I don't have that problem. Well, that's an excellent question. When you're in a game, and you have a low FOV, whether it be in a third-person or first-person game, you will notice a huge difference if you turn up the field of view. You can see more around you, and this gives you multiple advantages in almost every game. Now, here is how I believe FOV sliders should be set up. Number one, you should always have an FOV slider in your game that goes up to 120. Now, I know nobody will never, ever use an FOV that high because you get an opposite fisheye effect and it too can grant you motion sickness, but you should always, always go beyond what's necessary. The second thing is that you should always have more options. Take the Knights of the Force mod that I was showing off earlier. The features here are key to a, dare I say, almost perfect FOV slider. There are settings here for every aspect of the field of view, and this is one of the number one things that I look for when I jump into a new game. Sadly, I've never seen an FOV slider like this in any other game, but this modder had a very good head on his shoulders when he designed this. The third and final thing I look for in an FOV slider that I feel is very important, and many don't even consider, is having the ability to see your character as you change the FOV. Now, most of the time you get into the settings and you select a number, generally around 90 to 100, and you call it good. Now, the problem with this is every game is different. Some FOV sliders have a weird multiplier associated with them. So in that game, 85 might actually be 110 in a different game. And that can be a hassle to figure out. But if you're able to see your character, or if it comes to a first-person game, see what's in front of you while you change the FOV, then it becomes a lot easier to decide for yourself where you are comfortable. You won't even need numbers if it's done this way. I feel many people believe that FOV may not be very important, but I will always argue the opposite. If you ever get headaches while gaming, you may find out that it's probably because of the FOV, and simply tweaking that can make a huge difference. Not just benefiting you and your poor head, but also giving you a larger area of the screen to see. And this is never a bad thing. I have had to actually abstain from a few games simply because of the FOV, and that's unfortunate. I may sound as though I'm being a wimp, but it is truly out of my control, and I cannot think of any good reason that any developer would opt out of making an FOV slider for every single game they make, no matter what platform you play on.